I remember Nagabob on YouTube eating the brain strain chili. And he said, this is the worst ever. This is the worst ever. And today, this had to be the worst ever day for me too. And I asked the Holy Spirit, I have to somehow get help to come out of this day. It's that bad. And miraculously, the Holy Spirit came through. I had my doubts because I spent, you know, hours trying to come up with anything, some way to come out of this massive trauma that I was in from a dream. Really, it's too horrible to talk about. But this is a situation we're in now. I believe April 4th was the day that something got activated for sure. And this is just the worst. So, fortunately, the Holy Spirit, I said, you got to think outside the box, outside the box, outside the box. Boom. Finally, the answer came. And I'm in recovery mode right now. And I should be better tomorrow. So, I'm going to try and tape just a massive number of notes I tried to take today to dig out of this shock. I don't want to think about it. It's still causing problems. But what is the answer? What is the answer? That's the question. What is the answer? And it's amazing what happened. And I simply said, I call upon my treasure. I call upon my treasure to abide with me. I call upon my one true treasure. I call upon my one true treasure to come and abide with me this instant as it is. This is the decision of my one unsplit will. Okay, this is my decision of my unsplit will, my one will. So be it. This is my decision of my one will. How did I put it? It is the choice of my undivided, okay, that's a better way to put it. This is the choice of my undivided will that I no longer be apart from my one true treasure, my one true treasure. So I called upon my treasure, my true treasure, which is the treasure of everyone. That's why it's my treasure, because everyone has it, can't lose it. It's indivisible. I've never done this before. And when I did it, I realized that's what I've been waiting for. But it really took me being at the absolute brink of so many, basically, you know, the walls are closing in and about ready to get crushed. And then I said, I call upon my one true treasure. This is the choice of my undivided will. I go to where my one true treasure is. I go to where my one true treasure is. This is the choice of my undivided will. I go to where my one true treasure is. There to stay. There to stay. I go to where my one true treasure is. There to stay. This is the choice of my undivided will. So be it. So be it. I call upon my one true treasure to abide with me this instant as it is. This is the choice of my undivided will. This is the final resort, actually. And later I discovered something that was just an absolute mind blower, totally outside the box. I don't even know if I can explain it. It's so amazing. You know, I don't know if it's understandable, but it's hardly believable. But the insight popped for me. It popped. It seems as though the life that I've been through this life has really been an attempt to validate a previous life, to validate it. And in that lifetime, the ego said I had achieved the ultimate, you know, in personality status. And there's like a patriarch who took care of everybody's problems, you know, paid for their medical expenses, you know, bought them this, bought them that, whatever crisis, whatever emergency, whatever thing people needed, I helped them out. It was like Santa Claus. And then this lifetime, it seems as though I wanted to find out if all that giving had truly established me as, you know, as an ultimate personality, as a, you know, something permanent, you know, permanent personality. And so I put myself into a situation where I was the one who had to get help from other people. So I wanted to see what the gratitude was like. You know, when you help somebody, and what I found out was, no, people don't like having to accept charity. They don't like having to rely on other people. They're not really that grateful. That's what I've discovered. And so it didn't validate my previous experience, my previous personality. It invalidated it. I've never heard anything like this before, but I had a conversation, I think yesterday, in talking about gratitude and how when you're with someone who'd helped a lot of people out. And I said, did anybody really, you know, help come back gratitude? It's very, very few, very few. And really, nobody wants to be the object of charity and pity. And they hate it. They hate it. So helping someone else out in a charitable way doesn't establish you as some good person, as some ultimate loving person. People actually may can't stand you. They may hate your personality, but they say, I gotta take the money because I need it. But it's hell for them. It's really hell for them. So that's not the answer. That is not the true treasure. That is not true treasure. So I tried to establish that what I had done before was true treasure, and I found out it's not. It's not. If you're the matriarch or if you're the patriarch and you're the one who does everything for everybody, you are not beloved. You are not beloved. It's not true love. That is not true treasure. That is not. People will resent it. Resent it. Most people will greatly resent it, having to bow and scrape. And the fact is, you have to put up with their point of view. You have to act like they're right. You know, and you have to compromise yourself so much if you rely on someone else's money, where you can't be yourself. You just hate it. Absolutely hate it. So I realized that I wasn't beloved. I thought I was beloved before. I wasn't. I wasn't. The ego lied to me. The ego lied. People just didn't say anything because you don't dare. You don't dare say anything. That's what I've experienced in this life. You don't dare say anything. You have to just like be like a serf, you know, indentured servant, a slave. You don't have any rights to be yourself. So promoting this, you know, this matriarchal, patriarchal benefactor that's going to benefit people, you know, that doesn't work. That's not so. Then I discovered what I have to do is I have to call upon my one true treasure. You know, the treasure that's everywhere. The one treasure that's everywhere, that can't be lost, that can't be divided. Our true treasure. Because the treasure of money is not our true treasure. The treasure of using money to help others is not our true treasure. Uh, I gave other people the opportunity to take care of me. You know, got sick, let people take care of being sick, being poor, not being able to pay bills, all this stuff. So they had the opportunity to be the big helpers, the big benefactors, you know. But for me, it was absolute hell, absolute hell. And so I don't have, it's run out. You know, the whole thing has come to an end where my benefactors are no longer able to benefit me, you see. So at this point, I have no choice but to call upon my one true treasure to return to me. I've kept it away from me, kept it away on purpose, actually, on purpose. Now I call upon it because that's the only way out for me. And it'll bring to an end, of course, other people having to take care of me, having to help me, all this stuff. It'll bring an end to that. So they may be shaken up about that a little bit, but they've indicated they're pretty tired of it anyway. So I have to bring that to an end. Whereas I will have, you know, my treasure will come to me, and I won't be needy anymore. Won't need any help like that anymore. And I can say to people categorically, this, you have to do it this way. Don't keep working on the ego's treasure, which is really denying your true treasure. Really denying it. It has to do with personal treasure instead of the one treasure. My treasure is the treasure that everybody has. See, it's the treasure that is with everyone. That's why it's my treasure. That's the real treasure. I see everybody as totally blessed. That's the true treasure. Not like, oh, I'm blessed and I'm giving my blessing to other people. That's not it. Been there, done that. Been on both sides of the spectrum now. The one who gave blessings to others and the one who was blessed by others. That is not it. It's to see that everyone is blessed. That's your treasure. Everyone is already blessed. The blessing of God rests upon everyone. That is our true treasure that I call upon now. It's a total treasure. It's total treasure. So, you know, it's a radical step, but I had to take it. I delayed taking it for a long time. I knew at some point I had to make the call, and I just wouldn't do it. And I finally made the call. I've made the call. And continue to make the call. It's become essential. You cannot delay it forever, and you get into such a pickle that finally you have to make the call. And the Holy Spirit told me that this is what I said. Give me the words I need. And after a long struggle, finally, poof, just popped into my mind. I call upon my one true treasure. I go to where my one true treasure is. I go to where my one true treasure is there to stay. My undivided will has made this decision. This is the decision of my undivided will. I no longer choose to remain apart from my one true treasure. And my one true treasure is everywhere. It rests on everything, every place, everyone. That is our true treasure, actually. That is our true treasure. And we didn't put it there. God put it there. So our one true treasure comes from God, actually. Not from us. From God. I call upon my one true treasure, which is from God, to come abide with me and stay this instant, as it is, just as it is. This is the most potent final prayer affirmation, actually. It's the one that I had the trouble getting to. And being an extremist position, I finally had to cough it up. Because I was trying to figure out, well, maybe, you know, maybe I want to know how much good did I do? How much good did I do? How much did I help others? You know, stuff like that. Now, you don't really help anyone until you finally accept your true treasure, which is from God. And then that, we'll find out how helpful that is. That's truly helpful, though. Because people know that you're alerting them to where their true treasure is. The pressure's on in this world. I believe it started April 4th, 2019. 2014. I was alerted to that. At some level, the pressure's on in this world now. And so I expect those who are ready, I expect them, you know, to pop, to call upon their treasure, That's what should be expected now. Between now and, the 15th of April, probably. 15th of April is the blood moon. It's a very significant day at this point where we're at in world events and history, etc. So what is that? 9 days away. A little over a week. It's got to pop. No question about it. No choice about it. I've run out of options. So, and I expect it will. The heat's on in the world. The heat is on, as we have, I've said relentlessly over the years. Prepare, because you're going to get to the point where you're going to need to make the call. Like get on the phone, it's tough. Get on the phone with God and say, God, I'm calling my one true treasure to me. Now, that's it. That's the knockout blow. That's the end for the ego. I just wanted to evaluate everything as much as possible. But at some point, you just cannot keep evaluating forever. You have to make a decision. Power of decision is within me. Why? My undivided will gives that power to me. My undivided will chooses my one and only true treasure to come to me, and I to go to where it is also. My one true treasure. Yeah. And so I've avoided going into other stuff today. The situation is actually so terrible in the world, beyond anything that I won't even talk about after what I experienced last night. That is not worth even talking about. It's going to bring us down. We don't want to be brought down. We want to make the call. So if within you go through some strains and stresses now and you say, whoa, this is too much. This is too much. I've got to think outside the box now. It just isn't, have to make that call. Thinking outside the box. Consider calling your one true treasure that you've been, saying not yet. Consider making that call, placing that call, swallowing your pride and say, okay, it's time to bring in the full deck. It's time to have that, put an end to this nonsense. It's now the time. Don't wait. The stuff that's going on in the world behind the scenes, as it were, what's really taking place is how to say it. You don't want to get caught up in that. You got to draw the line somewhere. And then that's what I did. I said, okay, that's it. That's it. That's enough. I'm calling in my one true treasure. That is, I've had enough. Puts an end to the foolishness. So But, you know, if you're sensitive, you will feel that the situation now is just, you've had enough. You're not gonna go along with it anymore. Enough's enough. The ego really is just, it's too terrible to even, focus on. So just say, okay, making the call now. I'm making that call. How long has it taken me? Since I knew I had to make the call, it's been like 10 years, a little bit over 10 years actually, that I've been trying to get to the point of making the call. And I knew it would happen. I knew I would get lost. I knew I'd be feeling just like, I want to fix it myself without bringing in my true treasure, but can't do it because I'm actually trying to experience what it's like to not have, any treasure, to not have it, to be without it. And can the ego supply it? Can the personality supply what we really need? No, cannot. It's no good being again, perpetual charity is no good. Our true treasure is with us always. We're not poor. It's the end of poverty for me. It's the end of poverty. It's the end of neediness. It's the end of being a beggar, a bum, a beggar, a candlestick maker, a butcher, a baker, a candlestick maker. It's the end of scraping by, just barely scraping by, all this, scarcity, neediness, fear, anxiety, everything that comes with that. I'm saying, okay, that's enough of that. That's enough of that. And I really haven't thought much about the ramifications. I really don't want to. I can't afford to. I just have to keep making the call. I know it's going to work out well. I was tipped off to that 10 years ago. So I've calmed down a little bit from this morning, which was my psyche was just crumbling, because I cannot fix it without my treasure. I want true treasure. I can't fix the situation. I'm not able to. So then I remembered, oh yeah, I can call upon that. And Jesus tells us, call upon your one true treasure. Call upon it. That's what you have to do. Just give it a call. Call upon it. See, don't ask for someone else to give something to you. Call upon your own treasure. See, this is what he's saying. I read something in A Course in Miracles. Maybe I can, let me see. Maybe I'll read this here. It triggered this realization, what I needed to do indirectly. Let me see here. The function of the teacher of God is called the function of the teacher of God. And in reading this, I said, yeah, that's just spot on. It's just right. And he said something in here. And well, let's take a listen to this about you have to make the call for your treasure. Don't say, can you give me some of your treasure? I don't have any. No, you have to make the call for your own treasure. Okay, so he said, the function of the teacher of God, if the patient must change his mind in order to be healed, what does the teacher of God do? Can he change the patient's mind for him? Certainly not. For those already willing to change their minds, he has no function except to rejoice with them, for they have become teachers of God with him. He has, however, a more specific function for those who do not understand what healing is. These patients do not realize they have chosen sickness. On the contrary, they believe that sickness has chosen them, nor are they open-minded on this point. The body tells them what to do, and they obey. They have no idea how insane this concept is. If they even suspected it, they would be healed. Yet they suspect nothing. To them, the separation is quite real. To them, God's teachers come to represent another choice which they had forgotten. The simple presence of a teacher of God is a reminder. His thoughts ask for the right to question what the patient has accepted as true. As God's messengers, his teachers are the symbols of salvation. They ask the patient for forgiveness for God's Son in his own name. They stand for the alternative. With God's word in their minds, they come in benediction, not to heal the sick, but to remind them of the remedy God has already given them. It is not their hands that heal. It is not their voice that speaks the word of God. They merely give what has been given them. Very gently, they call to their brothers to turn away from death. Behold, you Son of God, what life can offer you? Would you choose sickness in place of this? Not once do the advanced teachers of God consider the forms of sickness in which their brother believes. To do this is to forget that all of them have the same purpose and therefore are not really different. They seek for God's voice in this brother who would so deceive himself as to believe God's Son can suffer. And they remind him that he did not make himself and must remain as God created him. They recognize illusions can have no effect. The truth in their minds reaches out to the truth in the minds of their brothers so that illusions are not reinforced. They are thus brought to truth. Truth is not brought to them. So are they dispelled not by the will of another, but by the union of the one will with itself. And this is the function of God's teachers, to see no will as separate from their own, nor theirs as separate from God's. So, I sort of got the feel from that, of something. And I realized you cannot rely on somebody else's will, as if wills were separate, someone else's will to will something to you. You have to act from your own realization of the undivisible will and make the decision for yourself. For we have called sickness unto ourselves. I realize I have called this trouble I have in my life to myself to try and determine if what I did previously, what the merit was, you know. So I have to decide to call upon my true treasure, one only true treasure, which can only come from a unified will, or from an undivided will. Not unified, that means they're two, they're unified. No, an undivided will. I think Jesus says, will unified with itself, or something like that. Let's see what it said. It's, but by the union of one will with itself. The union of one will with itself. This is just a way of talking. The union of one will with itself. But anyway, that triggered something somehow. I suddenly, out of nowhere, just said, ah, I go to where my treasure is. I go to where my treasure is this instant. As it is, I go to where my treasure, my one and only treasure is. I go to where my treasure is. I go to where my treasure is. That's the root of this call is that I go to where my treasure is. I call upon my treasure right now as it is. I call upon my treasure. I call upon my treasure. I go to where my treasure is. Whichever form you like, I go to where my treasure is. And right now, this instant as it is, I go to where my treasure is, there to stay. There to stay. No longer do I choose to be apart from my treasure. We have this infinite treasure, and it's just waiting for us to call it, actually. It cannot impose itself upon us as if it were a separate will. See, this is the problem. As long as we keep believing in split will, we're caught up in duality. Caught up in duality. No, this treasure is my treasure. This is my treasure. and I call upon it from my undivided will, from my one will, from the one will. I call upon it. Only the undivided will can call upon our true treasure, because our undivided will is our true treasure. Really, it really is. It's calling, it's will calling upon itself, the one will calling upon itself, as Jesus said. This is our treasure. And it, you know, it puts to rest all everything else, all the fakes, all the fake treasure. You know, no more dealing with fakes. And as a benefit of this, we may remember when we're young, we may have flashbacks to when we were young and things seemed so much better, we were so much lighter and happier, and we felt like we lived in a, you know, treasure. And then we're thinking back then, now, and we think, oh, those are childhood memories, I don't want to regress to my childhood. No, the actual fact of the matter is, that was when we had a better sense of our treasure. We just lost the sense of our treasure in this world. So we're merely going back to experiencing our treasure. That's all we're doing. That's all we're doing. We're not reconnecting with our childhood. We're reconnecting with our treasure. Big difference. We're reconnecting with our treasure right here, right now. We don't need to try to live on some memory of childhood. No. That's not it at all. That finally solved this problem. This is like one of the core problems. We're not trying to just merely hold on to some memory of childhood when things seem better. We are calling upon that same treasure that was there in childhood, that is still here now. We're calling upon that treasure right here now, just as it is, right here now as it is. I'm calling upon my true, one and only true treasure right now. My true treasure from God right now. And so this is an extreme measure, but we're in extremis, the world. There's no question about it. After what I've seen the last couple days, as a matter of fact, I made a video last night, which I didn't even post because it was too shocking to even post. I uploaded, but I didn't make it public because too shocking, too terrible. And then after the dream last night, it would distract people. But let me just say that the world's in extremis right now, in death throes. Actually, it's in death throes right now. And no way should anybody wait any longer to make the call. No way. And I got a report. One of our great viewers seems to have made the call and gotten a tremendous response already. You know, this is what is expected right now. This is what's expected. It is the time to make the call. It is the time to make the call now. That's what's up. So, doing this extreme last ditch resort effort, you know, the nuclear option of calling upon our true treasure, now that's necessary right now. So what I'm doing is I'm encouraging everybody to do this because it's necessary. Don't play with fire any longer. Don't mess around any longer. Enough's enough. The world is a way worse place than anybody realizes right now. Almost inconceivably worse than anyone can realize what's coming, what the crop has been sown, what kind of seeds have been sown in this world, right? You know, when they're little sprouts, when you sow the seeds, people say, ah, I don't know, it's not a big deal. And then the sprouts come up and you say, ah, little sprouts. And then they grow a little bit and you say, ah, you know, there's a lot of weeds there. And then we don't pay much attention, and one day we go into the garden, and the garden has these incredibly noxious weeds, tares. And you just, you know, freak out and say, oh my God, this is, you know. So what kind of seeds have been sown in this world? You saw the sowing of them. Well, they're coming to full size now. Full size. And, so, it's decision time. The power of decision rests within me. The power of decision rests within me. I did a video on will, how it's impossible to split our will. Our will is unsplittable. And that's very important. That's the key. We cannot split our will. We can disassociate, project and disassociate, project and disassociate. Cannot split our, cannot split it. It's still one. It's still one. That is our treasure. And we call upon everything that our one will gives to us, our one true treasure. Now, the world may not like that. That way we're not going to worry about that. We're not going to worry about that. What they like, what those noxious weeds like and dislike, we're not going to worry about that. We're just going to call upon our one true treasure right now. I call upon my one true treasure right now. I call upon this very instant. I call upon my one true holy treasure, my one true treasure of holiness right now. I call upon my one true treasure of holiness right now to abide with me. I call upon my one true treasure of holiness to abide with me this instant as it is. I call upon my one true treasure of holiness to abide with me this instant as it is. It's narrow escape right now, narrow escape. Went to the, you know, the brink, very edge, and time to pull back from that edge. Enough's enough. Time to get serious and time to put an end to this nonsense. Time to put an end to this nonsense here. We've seen enough. We've seen enough. So put an end to the nonsense. I call upon my one true treasure of holiness this very instant. I call upon my one true treasure of holiness to abide with me this very instant as it is. I go to my one, where my one true treasure of holiness is. I go this very instant as it is. I go to my one true treasure of holiness where it is. I now go there. So I asked the Holy Spirit for some, what could I say during the whole day? Just keep it going. And this is what I go to my treasure. I go to my treasure. I go to my treasure. I call upon my treasure. I call upon my treasure. And I was able to do it during church the whole time. I didn't lose it. I was able to keep it going all the time. Nothing could knock it out. Nothing could knock it out of my mind. It was the best affirmation I've ever had. I call upon my one true treasure this instant, right now. I make the call to my one true treasure right now. I make the call right now to my one true treasure right now. And you can say that all during the day. What I'm asking everyone to do is to literally all day, I call my one true treasure. I call my treasure. I go to my treasure where it is. I go to my treasure, I call my treasure. I go to my treasure, I call my treasure. I go to my one true treasure, I call my one true treasure. And use it all day. Use it all day. Don't mess around anymore. Don't mess around anymore with what's going on. You don't want to, under any circumstances, okay? I don't care what the circumstances are. Do not delay anymore. Do not mess around anymore for any reason. So don't even think about a reason. Just do the practice. I call upon my one true treasure. I call upon my true treasure. I go to my true treasure right now. I go to my true treasure right now. I call upon my true treasure right now. This is, I am calling my true treasure right now. I'm calling it in. Calling it in. Calling it in. Jesus assures us it will respond. Calling upon God, actually. The response will come. Where everything else failed, this will not fail. Where everything else seemed to come up short, this will not come up short. It is the nuclear option. For sure. It is the, you know, the last resort. The last resort. Nothing after that. It's the last resort. And generally, we procrastinate up to the last second, at least I do. We don't want to have to call upon the last resort. We think, our pride says, no, I want to be able to fix it without having to call upon my true treasure. I want to be able to see if I can handle it without that, you know. But no. Okay, very great. We will see going forward, but don't wait for anything. Just call upon your one true treasure. Just make the decision. You're going to make the call. Make the call. It's your treasure, because your will is undivided. Your will is undivided, so you can make that call. A divided will can't make that call. An undivided will can make that call. So just make the call, and then you need to realize, hey, my will is undivided. It actually is. It actually is. It's not divided. Giver and receiver really are the same. Giver and receiver really are the same. So we don't need to play this silly game anymore. God's treasure rests upon all. Cannot lose it. It's impossible to lose our true treasure, our one and only true treasure. It's impossible to lose it. So I call upon my treasure. I go to my treasure right now. I go to my treasure right now. All right. Very great. That's it for this one. I'll try to post this one. I think I'm going to post this one.